Hello, Fontana. I'm Mayor Aquanetta Warren. Today is a beautiful, beautiful day in Fontana. And as we talk about COVID-19, we always want to give you up-to-date information on what's going on not only in Fontana, but around the region. I know you're saying, Mayor, you're a little bit too excited, and it's more than the weather. You know why? Today is a big day. We've got a special program for all of you. You might know that the Inland Empire is home to America's fastest growing airport. 3 years running, hear me? 3 years with that designation. It's true, Ontario International Airport has seen an amazing, amazing growth. One of the major driving forces is my guest today, Mayor Pro Tem Alan Wapner from the City of Ontario. And he's also the president of Ontario International Airport Authority. As a matter of fact, before COVID, whenever I would go into the airport, I would grab his pictures and give him a big smack on it. Because I said, I know him. Treat me differently. No, I'm just kidding. He's a great man. He and I serve also on the San Bernardino Transportation Authority. And it's always great to hear him just talk. And here he is right here amongst us in our council chambers. So, welcome, Alan.
Thank you.
Now, I got a question for you. As someone who's been around the IE for many years, I'm really impressed with what has happened at the Ontario Airport. And I'm a great traveler, so I know the changes. But it wasn't that long that Ontario belonged to Los Angeles. I know that I shouldn't say that, but that's the truth. But now the authority and the control is with all of you. So tell me, how do we get it back?
Well, first of all, I'll let you know that it's with all of us, because we would have never gotten it back had it not been for you and for the city of Fontana and for all the folks in the region. How we got it back, a very, very long story cut short, is we recognized that the city of LA had owned us about 50 years.
And
we
was also it 50 years?
65.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
Since 1965.
Okay.
And we also noticed that in recent years they weren't paying attention to us. In fact, just the opposite. They were doing all they could do to bring us down in order to increase business at LAX. And I was a liaison between the City of Ontario and the LA World Airports, and I was at a meeting, and I heard conversations like, why would we want to help Ontario? Well, we have plenty of capacity here. And as soon as I left that meeting, I was in the parking lot, and I gave a call to our city manager, your former city manager, Greg Devereaux. I said, Greg, we're getting this airport back. That was back in 2008. It was a long, long journey,
eventually
we were able to get the airport back from LA. We signed an agreement, and once we took control, as you said, it's just been growing ever since.
You know, I remember being in an elevator in D.C. with the prior mayor, Antonio, and I was all up in his ear because we grew up together. I said, you know, you're wrong, right? He said, we're working with Alan, we're working with Ontario, stop it, Aquanetta. And I'm so happy that happened. But once the airport returned to Ontario, we started seeing a return of all the flights. I mean, for a while there, we had to go to LAX for certain flights. Suddenly, all these new airlines and a strong increase in passenger traffic began. What are some of the highlights you can point to?
Well, certainly we knew that we had a huge pent-up demand. We knew as soon as we got control of the airport and implemented our business plan that things would move forward, and that's exactly what's happening. So we've made a more convenient location for our passengers. We've increased the amount of concessions inside, but more than anything else, we've been able to lower the cost for the airlines to do business there. As a result, we've increased international business, daily flights nonstop to Taiwan through China Airlines.
Wow.
Incredible for the city of Ontario and for the region. Volaris. We have other international carriers wanting to come in. The existing airlines have all expanded operations across the country, and we've added new airlines. Hawaiian Airlines, daily nonstops to Honolulu. We have, you know, I guess what I'm saying is that with the support of the region, and I want to emphasize that, it would not have ever occurred had our friends in all the cities in Southern California not helped us. And I'll tell you, what really pushed us over, you talked about Antonio, and obviously I had many conversations with him. What really brought it together was after Eric Garcetti took over,
yes.
We had a meeting with Senator Dianne Feinstein, and she loves our airport for some reason. So we met with her, And I'll never forget, it was a restaurant in downtown LA, and there was a private room with glass all around. And of course, both Mayor Garcetti and the senator had their own entourage. And she said, everybody out of the room, everybody out of the room, but Mayor Garcetti and Allen and myself.
Wow.
Aquanet, we sat down there, and the first thing the senator said, she goes, you know what, man? I have settled world peace. I've signed world treaties. This is an easy one. Right? Now, this is after I've been, we're doing this for 10 years. And she said, Mayor Garcetti, what do you want? He goes, we'd just like to get our investment back. Allen, what do you want? I just want to get the airport back to the region. Any reason this can't happen? No. And that was it. Until we got it to lawyers, and then it took a few years after the lawyers got it. So since that point, we found that we could lower the cost of doing business. One, there were about 500 acres on and around the airport that could be developed.
Wow.
That never were. The dilapidated buildings, cars that were breaking down. It was just a matter of going in there and do what you do here in Fontana and the rest of us in our region, is doing the right thing, fixing things up, maintaining them, and really presenting a business plan that could serve our purposes.
And I tell you, you've done a phenomenal job. I love going over there. But that pandemic we just had hit the travel and aviation industry so hard. How was it for Ontario?
Well, it was devastating, obviously. You know that our economy is built a lot on hospitality, the convention center, the arena, and of course the airport, and it's that domino effect.
Right.
If the airport goes down, and it was about 95% reduction,
not just
at our airport, at all airports. That means that the convention center can't thrive. They couldn't have conventions anyway. The arena shut down, everything shut down, which eliminated, as you know, parking taxes, bed taxes, everything else. So it's been tough.
Right.
However, you mentioned that we're the largest or the fastest growing airport. We're also the fastest recovering airport when it comes to post-pandemic.
That's
and
great.
Our Memorial Day numbers were way up.
Great.
And we're running about 70 or 80% of what we were pre-pandemic.
Wow.
Which has been great for the entire economy, for the whole Indian Empire.
You know, if you got a great foundation, it'll come back. You know, what can you tell us about the proposed tunnel that take passengers in and out of the airport? And tell us about that tunnel. You know, listening to Kurt Hagman and you talk about it, I just get goosebumps.
Well, you know, we always knew that we'd have connectivity between the airport and other modes of travel. And we began with a connection with the Metrolink by the County Transportation Authority subsidizing all lift rides back and forth. And we knew it was going to take progression. But as you and I both know, Supervisor Hagman, he thinks a million times a minute. Mr. Technology. And believe it or not, he somehow hooked up with Elon Musk. And before we knew it, we were already planning this tunnel between Metrolink and the airport. So I want to thank Supervisor Hagman for his foresight, and it's moving forward pretty quickly. And what we're finding, it's going to be much, much, much less expensive to do it this way than just bringing rail into the airport. And then, of course, with the recent events of Brightline bringing the high-speed rail from Las Vegas into Rancho Cucamonga,
right,
and, of course, the Metrolink station being served by the tunnel to the airport, it's all connected just the way we like it.
This is becoming a real hub for innovative ideas. This morning we talked about technology, and I think even we're going to get the attention of the White House because they're talking about technology too. If we could shift gears a little though, Ontario Airport is also a major freight and supply chain hub. Here in Fontana, we've got some of the country's most sophisticated ground transportation companies operating right out of this town. For our region, this is good, or is it not good?
Well, you know, you and I both recognize the fact that because of our great transportation system, Fontana, Ontario, all the cities in this area are really at the hub of transportation. Ontario, we have three interstate highways running through our town, two railroads, an airport, and Fontana shares the same resources. So we've always been a place that logistics centers like to locate to. The airport, actually, we're the first airport to have a UPS hub, a FedEx hub, and Amazon. And we have other carriers interested in coming over. Now, what does that mean? Obviously, that means a big demand on logistics and warehouses throughout the Inland Empire. And some people say, well, you know, maybe warehouses aren't the best thing. If you look at what we've gone through the pandemic and the decrease in brick and mortar stores and people becoming more reliant on e-commerce, we need to take advantage of that while we can with this economy. And had it not been for our large cargo presence, and again, we're the largest cargo airport in the country, we would have never made it through the pandemic because it really balanced out the loss of passengers that we had. It makes things much easier. People like, or warehouses like to be near the airport because it cuts a full day off of their shipping time. And of course, our residents and the folks in the area love to have that. They get it very, very quickly. So I guess the best thing to say is we certainly understand the impact to the Inland Empire, but then we also understand some of the impacts, negative impacts it causes. So it's up to folks like you and me and others in the area to make sure that we mitigate any negative impacts by having these warehouses in the area. We got to make sure we clear congestion of the trucks. We got to make sure that we provide a clean, environmentally friendly area and create lots of jobs.
That's the bottom line. Environmentally friendly and creating great jobs so that we don't have our residents on the freeway 2 and 3 hours going to work in LA County, San Diego. We don't want that. Okay, here's the big question. What's next for Ontario Airport and what can we do here in Fontana to help?
Fly Ontario, babe. I'll tell you, what's next for Ontario is we're going to continue growing. We'll be making some announcements about some future airlines and cargo air carriers are going to be coming. You're going to see a lot of development going on and around the airport. What used to be vacant land will be developed. And you're going to see more prosperity for all of us. And what can you do here in Fontana? Fly Ontario. And please, I want to thank all of your residents and businesses for supporting the airport. It would have never occurred without it. And you, Mayor Warren, I mean, what can I say? We've been best friends for a long, long time.
Oh, yes.
But we all believe in the fact that it's the region, that what benefits Ontario benefits Fontana, benefits Rancho Cucamonga. And so we're going to make the airport successful. And that's all there is to it. You're going to continue seeing more amenities inside the airport, more restaurants, more stores. And really a better, more convenient experience for our passengers.
Well, I'm already a fan. Our population is a fan. Everybody's a fan of that airport. It belongs to all of us.
It does.
But I'm just so happy you and I can talk about anything. And anything you ever need, you know, all you have to do is call me.
Well, Ontario certainly always considered Fontana a great friend. We've done so many things together.
Yes, we have.
And we certainly look forward to a bright future. I'll tell everybody, your mayor, he's the best. Don't tell my mayor that, but your mayor's the best.
Well, that's only because I have great, great friends like you.
Oh, stop. This is a mutual admiration, right?
And just ask, what should I do? Well, Alan, thanks so much for joining us today. And when we have these interviews, we want to make sure that all of you know what we know. But remember, Fontana together moves Fontana forward. And thank you for joining me today.
Thank you for inviting me.